What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to install and use the Clans Minecraft plugin. While playing with friends on your Minecraft server, some might want to form groups to continue their adventure. This allows the party of users to have better success at collecting resources, battling monsters, and building bases. By default, Minecraft doesn't allow for this type of feature and forces everyone to group by word of mouth. If you're wanting an official system for players to create these parties in-game, then consider using the Clans plugin. This allows you and others to make a clan, notifying all users in the server's chat whenever you send a message. There's even a teleportation feature to share a base with your clan members, along with custom add-ons to add extra features. To start the download process, head to the Clans page on Spigot's website and click Download Now in the top right corner. Save this file somewhere easily accessible on your computer. At the time of making this video, the Clans plugin hasn't been updated since 2020, and it's only been tested on Minecraft 1.16 and below. However, we have confirmed that this works for 1.19 and it shouldn't be problematic. Additionally, if you're planning to install official add-ons for the plugin, keep in mind that issues may arise due to their outdated versions. To start the server installation, first, make sure you're running a plugin-compatible server type like Paper or Spigot. After that, stop the server and click FTP file access near the top left, log in, and then find and enter the plugins directory from the list. Once you're there, press Upload in the top left and then drag the Clans file into the upload area. And once this reaches 100%, you can use your server name at the top of the page to return to the main panel and restart the server. After joining the server, you should have immediate access to Clans and its features. Almost everything from this plugin can be edited and tailored to your server, so let's go over some of the changes you can make and the things you can do. While in your Minecraft server, try running the clan create name command in the chat. This should allow you to make a group for others to join, which is confirmed by a return message. By default, there's only 5 characters allowed for the name of your party, but this can be tweaked to anything you want, even allowing unique colors if configured properly. After creating a clan, you might notice a new chat format when sending messages to others. This depends on your current server's setup though, since it may appear differently if you have a standalone plugin to manage this aspect. As for managing your newly created clan, there are a few features to keep in mind. These include inviting and kicking members, and viewing the group's statistics. This plugin keeps track of the total kills by everyone and sorts them in a list from every clan. Inviting members to your clan requires the clan invite user command. Once you do this, the player cannot be uninvited. When someone receives one, they can run clan accept in the chat to join the group. And keep in mind that anyone can leave your clan since it only requires the clan leave command. Another way to leave the group is by being kicked out by the leader, which is done with the clan kick player command. You can also view stats of your own clan. This provides you with all members and total kills by everyone, which is done with the clan stats name command. Alternatively, you can view the top 10 groups by only using clan stats in the chat. This acts as a leaderboard, which can technically be implemented into holograms or other areas in your server with the right plugins and configuration. One of the most exciting features from this plugin is the ability to share bases with your members. This acts like setting homes with other Minecraft plugins, but it is only for your group. Teleporting to your base requires you to first use clan set base at your desired location, and then you can run clan base to teleport back to it. There's a few files that you can access with the FTP panel to start editing, such as config and messages. This comes in handy if you're wanting to completely remove a group or simply make manual changes. Head towards the FTP file access and log in, and then enter into the plugins, clans, and settings directory. Once you're there, press edit to the right of one of the files to reveal the contents, make any necessary changes, and then click save at the top, and return to the main panel to restart the server and apply the edits. If you're wanting to completely control how players use clans on your Minecraft server, then you'll need a permission management plugin like Luck Perms. There are no permissions by default, but enabling them keeps it so only certain players can use certain commands. Sometimes players might want more abilities and features for their clan. This motivated the developer of clans to create several official add-ons for the main plugin. For example, you can install Rename to allow leaders to change their group's name. Another one called Chest allows clan members to share items in a double chest GUI via a command. Other add-ons are available in the clan spigot page near the bottom for you to review. Now, before we jump into the common issues, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. In some cases, you or others might be unable to make clans on the server. This might be happening because the plugin is incompatible with the Minecraft version you selected. Only 1.16 has been officially tested, but 1.19 should work fine without problems. If newer versions or older ones aren't working properly, then consider switching to a compatible version. If you install an add-on for clans and it won't work, it might be incompatible with your Minecraft version. This is similar to the issue before, but it isn't easily resolved due to the add-ons having different designs. In this situation, your best bet is to try the other builds or simply remove it from the FTP panel. If your permissions aren't working, remember you have to enable them in the config file to get them to work. The exact setting is permissions enabled, and it must be formatted properly when making changes. Minecraft is a game that is always better with friends, and having a plugin to keep that friend group controlled is a game changer. Now that you have separate bases, chats, and a stats page, you'll have everything you need to defeat the game with friends by your side.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.